grazie Marco.
Giornata di concreti che tradizionalmente è dedicata ad un seminario, ad un evento di discussione scientifica di una delle sedi del raggruppamento nazionale. Quest'anno il direttivo dell'associazione AIDI ha deciso di dedicare questo secondo giorno alla diffusione dei risultati di un progetto relativo a Industria 4.0 per l'efficientamento della manutenzione e delle operations di produzione. E il seminario sottende appunto un progetto PON, il progetto REACT, a cui partecipano tre sedi universitarie e sei partner industriali. Il relatore, nonché responsabile scientifico del progetto, è il professor Filippo Emanuele Ciarapica dell'Università Politecnica delle Marche, che è capofila accademico dello stesso progetto. Abbiamo pensato anche a questo argomento in quanto diciamo, il filo conduttore della maggior parte dei progetti dei dottorandi che hanno partecipato alla prima giornata di questo workshop è in un modo o in un altro sempre correlato alle tecnologie di Industria 4.0 applicate appunto ai sistemi di produzione, alla manutenzione, alla logistica o alla gestione dell'energia. Io ringrazio il professor Ciarrapica, al quale facciamo anche gli auguri in quanto è da poco, in tempi relativamente recenti, passato in prima fascia, e lo ringraziamo per la cortese disponibilità, ringraziando peraltro anche il presidente, il professor Ferrari, e il direttivo di AIDI per averci dato la possibilità di diciamo, organizzare il PhD on the go presso la sede Unisanio, seppur in maniera in remoto, ma abbiamo cercato di fare del nostro meglio per poter tramutare questa difficoltà in un'opportunità, creando le condizioni affinché tutti potessero accedere. Bene, io a questo punto, dopo questa breve introduzione, lascio la parola al professor Ciarapica. E diciamo, auguro a tutti un'ottima e proficua possibilità di trarre vantaggio da quanto il professor Ciarapica ci comunicherà oggi. Grazie ancora.
Grazie Matteo. Innanzitutto buongiorno a tutti. Dunque, in accordo con Matteo ho preparato questa presentazione in inglese, quindi se per voi va bene la produrrò in inglese. E ecco
Sì,
come.
certo, la lingua ufficiale del workshop è l'inglese.
Benissimo, va bene. So, I think we can start. So as you can see from the title of this presentation, this focuses on a key enabled technology of Industry 4.0 and in particular on the digital twin. Okay. The main points of this presentation are summarized in these bullet points. And in particular, after a short introduction of this topic, of the digital twin, I move to explain the main phases of the developing, for the developing of a digital twin. Later, I will present the standard under development about digital twin. Then I move on explaining you a case study that we are carrying out in our university. And finally, I conclude highlighting some critical aspects of this system. Well, various definitions of digital twin exist, but there are some elements that remain the same in every definition. These common elements can be identified by breaking down the name between digital and twin. In particular, twin means we have to develop an high fidelity virtual replica of a physical asset, often developed using computer-aided design tools. While digital means a real-time two-way communication for simulation purposes and decisions that aid future for product and service enhancement. So a valid question that a company maybe is why the need to create a digital twin. First of all, I can highlight that through the assessment of ongoing states, the diagnosis of historical problems and the prediction.
Filippo, please, sorry to interrupt you. Please start your cam so that the others who doesn't, maybe someone doesn't know you, may see you in face also from YouTube for the others. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Right. Matteo, sorry, I have some problem with the webcam. Anyway, I think you can hear me. Matteo, if you agree, I continue in this way, and after I will open the webcam. So, first of all, I can highlight that through the assessment of the ongoing states, the diagnosis of historical problems, and the prediction of the future trends, digital twin can provide more comprehensive support for decision making of a wide spectrum of operations. In addition, through digital twin, it is also possible to digitize expert experience, which can be documented, transferred, and modified through an enterprise to reduce the knowledge gap. In this context, digital twin can be useful for training of users, operators, maintenance, and service providers. Moreover, through simulation tools and virtual reality tools, digital twin can deepen the operations understandings of complex physical entities and processes. So digital twin provides a means to simulate and investigate scenarios that are otherwise too costly to explore. Well, the maturity of this technology attracted attention from both academia and wide range of industry, including healthcare and urban planning. As you can see in the figure on the left, digital twin applications can be found in smart city, construction, healthcare, agriculture, cargo shipping, automobile, and so on. This application of a digital twin was developed by leading enterprises such as General Electric, Siemens, Ansys, Dassault, and so on. Just to mention some examples, for civil engineering, Dassault uses its 3D experience platform to build a Singapore digital twin to support urban planning, construction, and health. In the healthcare field, SimCure developed a patient-based digital twin for treating aneurysms, while based on Predict platform, General Electric built a digital wind farm by creating a digital twin for every wind turbine to optimize maintenance strategy, improve reliability, and increase energy production. The figure on the right shows an overview of product lifecycle management phases addressed in the digital twin. Most applications related to manufacturing phase. And in particular, in this phase, digital twin aims at making production processes efficient, reliable, and adaptable via production digitalization to better react to shifting customer trends, to support job scheduling. In many cases, digital twin is used for fault prediction and diagnosis, optimization of production aspects, such as manufacturing speed and real-time geometrical quality control, for instance, for welded components. A recent research forecast the digital twin market to grow to $27.06 billion by 2025, an approximate tenfold increase from $2.26 billion in 2017. From publication point of view and scientific point of view, as shown in the diagram on the left, there is an exponential increase of number of publications over the past 5 years, from 2015 to 2019. Most of these papers come from Chinese research, followed by USA, as you can see in the diagram on the right. From historical point of view, we can highlight that the evolution of digitalization has gone through four progressive stages: digital enablement, digitalization assistance, digital control and link, and cyber physical integration. So in particular, digital enablement refers to the process of converting paper documents into digital forms without making any different in-kind changes to the process itself. Due to the limitation of digitalization tools, initially only the most essential information is digitalized for storage, processing, and transfer. With the extensive application of technology, such as computer-aided design, computer-aided engineering, and manufacturing, in the 1980s, the paradigm of digitalization shifted toward assisting engineers to work with computers effectively. With the development of the internet and advanced control technology in 1990, business digitalization provided new revenue and value-producing opportunities for enterprises. With the advancement of information technology, especially the emergence of a new generation of information technology, such as Internet of Things, cloud computing, big data analytics, and artificial intelligence, the digitalization process is greatly accelerating. Specifically, concerning the digital twin, we can underline some important steps. So the concept of digital twin was first introduced by Greaves during his presentation of Product Lifecycle Management Conference in 2003. From the conception of a virtual design, digital equivalent to physical product, the debut of digital twin take place at National Aeronautics and Space Administration in 2012. Moreover, in 2014, Greaves published the white paper about digital twin, according to which the basic of digital twin model consists of three main parts. First of all, the physical product and real space. Secondly, virtual products in virtual space, and finally, the connection of data and information that tie the virtual and real products together. Then, digital twin was applied in Industry 4.0 paradigm by Siemens in 2016. As already shown, more and more researchers devoted to the digital twin have come up since 2016. And began to grow exponentially. Finally, ISO organizations start the procedure to develop some standards specifically on digital twin since 2018. Well, regarding the development of a digital twin, we can highlight that this is not a completely new concept. A digital twin can be developed as a combination and integration of some existing technologies. Moreover, there are many ways to make a digital twin. As shown in the bar chart of the figure taken from ISO documents, the most common technologies used for developing the digital twin are simulation, modeling techniques, artificial intelligence algorithms, and IoT solutions. An interesting classification of different tools used for digital twin has been proposed recently by Quigley and others in 2020. This classification divide digital twin tools among tools for physical world, tools for connection, for digital twin modeling, for digital twin data, and finally for digital twin cells. Now I move to describe in detail these different tools. Regarding tools for physical world, as shown in the figure, the first step to reflect the physical world is to measure the parameters, such as size, shape, structure, density, and so on, about the physical entity. The existing measurement technologies include laser measurement, image recognition, convection measurement, and many other measurements. To synchronize a virtual model with its real-world counterpart, real-time data about torque, pressure, speed, acceleration, vibration, voltage, temperature, and many others must be collected. For these purposes, depending on the target of the digital twin, the correct sensors and actuators must be selected. The tools for physical world can be divided into tools for cognizing physical world and tools for controlling the physical world. Cognizing different aspects of the physical world is the foundation of digitalization. In this context, IoT is one of the main drivers of the digital twin. Besides, the virtual models run in parallel to the physical assets. Driven by sensor data, digital twins flex operational behavior that deviates from simulated behavior. For example, a petroleum company may steal sensor data from offshore oil rigs that operate continuously. A tool for controlling the physical world can make physical entities run more efficiently and securely based on feedback information. Digital twin can adjust the physical world mainly through controlling the operation with feedback. Therefore, the tools for changing the physical world mostly are control related. Regarding tool for digital twin modeling, these tools involve geometric modeling, physical modeling, behavioral modeling, and rule modeling. In particular, geometric models describe a physical entity in terms of its geometry, shape, embodiment, and appearance with appropriate data structures, which are suitable for computer information conversion and processing. the physical model adds information of occurrences, such as dimensional tolerance, shape tolerance, position, and surface problems. Has, moreover, material information, such as material type, performance, heat treatment requirements, hardness, and so on. And finally, adds assembly information, such as mating relationship and assembly order. Behavioral model describes various behaviors of a physical entity to fulfill functions, respond to change, interact with others, adjust internal operations, and so on. This is a simulation of a physical behavior that involves multiple models, such as state model, dynamic model, evaluation model, and so on. These models can be developed based on finite state machines, Markov chain, and ontology-based modeling methods. While rule model describes the rule extracted from historical data, expert knowledge, and predefined logic. The rule equipment, the virtual model with inability to reason, judge, evaluate, optimize, and predict. Finally, model verification, validation, and accreditation can improve model accuracy and model simulation. Well, in the figure of this slide, a list of most used software for modeling phase are presented. These tools are divided by software focused on monitoring, simulation, prediction, and verification. For example, as geometric modeling tool, a performance test device for the digital twin model of a CNC machine tool is established in SolidWorks. Another example about physical modeling tools comes from Ansys. Through the finite element analysis by Ansys, sensor data can be used to define real-time boundary conditions for geometric models and integrate wear coefficient or performance degradation into the model. As an example of behavior modeling tools, based on the soft PLC platform Codesys, the motion control system of CNC machine tools can be designed. The motion control system can interact information with multi-domain model of three-axis CNC machine tools, established in the software platform MWorks through the socket communication. In this way, it can realize the motion control of a single axis and three-axis interpolation of CNC machine tools. Regarding the rule modeling tool, an example regards the machine learning ability by PTC ThingWorx. Upon age computing system, it can monitor sensors to automatically learn the normal state of a pump while it is running. Based on learning rules, digital twin can recognize abnormal operating conditions, detect abnormal patterns, and predict future trends. Data management tools are necessary to link information obtained from devices and services to be provided. First of all, data can be collected through software application programming interfaces and open database interfaces. Data transmission technology includes wire and wireless transmission or data transmission. And in particular, for data transmission, it is necessary to explore the applicability of the high speed, low latency, high performance, and high secure data transmission process. Data storage is necessary to store the collected data for further processing analysis. and management. Due to the increasing volume and heterogeneity of multi-source digital twin data, traditional database technology are no longer used. Big data storage technologies such as distributed file storage, new SQL database, and cloud storage are growing attention. Data processing means extracting useful information from a large volume of incomplete, unstructured, and random raw data. The relevant technologies include data cleaning, data compression, data smoothing, reduction, transformation, and so on. Data fusion copes with multi-source data through synthesis, filtering, correlation, and integration. Finally, data visualization serves to present data analysis results in a straightforward, intuitive, and interactive manner. Well, in this figure, particularly in the bullet point of this figure, a short list of most used software for data management have been inserted for your information. Okay. The connection technology serves to ensure real-time interaction among different parts of the digital twin. The connection within digital twin means the communication, interaction, and exchange of information among physical entities, data center, service, and virtual home. At present, the inconsistency of interfaces, protocols, and standards is the bottleneck of the digital twin connection. Moreover, since human interacts with digital twin in both physical and virtual worlds, human-computer interaction technology, such as virtual reality, augmented reality, should be incorporated, as well as human-robot interaction and collaboration. So there are a number of tools for digital twin connection. Regarding these specific tools, I can mention PTC ThingWorx. It can act as a gateway between sensor and digital models to connect various smart devices in the IoT ecosystem. Moreover, MindSphere is a cloud-based open IoT operating system from Siemens that connects products, clients, system and machine. As another example, Jasper Control Center from Cisco can continuously monitor network conditions, device behavior, and IoT service status to ensure high service reliability through real-time diagnosis and proactive monitoring of connection status. Only to show you some example of these two of these software. It is important to say that there are a number of comprehensive tools that play multiple roles in digital twin. For instance, ANSYS software, not only modeling, but also providing simulation service, troubleshooting service, and many others. Similar comprehensive tools include Predict Siemens, MindSphere, the Soul 3D Experience, Spotcom, Beacon, and PTC ThingWorx, and many others. There are different types of services. I can mention application service that integrates multiple disciplines to achieve advanced monitoring, simulation, diagnosis, and process. Resource and knowledge services can be managed through industrial IoT platforms. This platform provides some supporting functions, such as survey publishing, querying, searching, smart matching, and recommendation. Online communication, online contracting, service evaluation, and many others. Platform-related technology include platform architecture, organization mode, operation, and maintenance management, security technologies, and many others. The tools for digital twin service application can be classified into platform service tools, simulation service tools, optimization service tools, diagnostic and prognostic service tools, as shown in the figure on the right. In particular, service platform tools integrate emerging technologies such as Internet of Things, big data, artificial intelligence. For example, the ThingWorx platform can connect the digital twin model to the product in operation to display sensor data and analyze results through web applications. ThingWorx platform could provide industrial protocol conversion, data acquisition, device management, big data analysis, and many other services. The diagnostic and prognostic service tools can provide, for instance, intelligent predictive maintenance strategy and reduce equipment downtime. For example, Hensys simulation platform helps to design the industrial IoT connection hardware and analyze the operational data created by this smart device to enable troubleshooting and predictive maintenance. In addition, integrated with data-driven methods such as machine learning, deep learning, neural networks, and system identification, MATLAB can be used to determine remaining useful life to inform operations on the most opportune time to service or replace. Well, regarding the standards under development about digital twin, I can highlight that in this period there is a strong activity. A first classification of these standards can be carried out according to vertical approach, as shown in this slide. I mean, vertical approach mean various industrial sectors are dealing with digital standards. A short list is mentioned in these bullet points on this slide. In particular, manufacturing, energy, smart city, farming, building, and healthcare sector constitute different technical committees and steering committee for developing specific standards on digital in there. At the moment, I'm personally involved in the development of a digital twin standard on manufacturing. Another classification of digital twin standard can be carried out according to an horizontal approach. I mean, taking into consideration the technology used in a digital twin. For instance, simulation, IoT, artificial intelligence, IT security, and so on. A short list of these standards that follow this approach are mentioned in the bullet point of this slide. Regarding the digital twin on manufacturing, ISO constitutes inside the technical committee 184, called Automation System and Integration, and in particular in the subcommittee S4, Industrial Data a working group, WD15, involved in the Digital Twin Framework for Manufacturing. This working group is committed in developing the standard 23247. This standard aims at defining a framework to support the creation of digital twins of observable manufacturing elements, including personnel, equipment, materials, processes, and many others. In general, a standard has to pass different stages before the publication. We completed now the draft of the international standard stage, and we are approaching the final approval stage for the publication of the standard. This specific standard is divided into four parts. The first one provides an overview of a digital twin for manufacturing, describes general principles, and provides requirements and guidance for developing a digital twin for manufacturing. In the second part, the part two, it provides goals and objectives, a reference model, and a functional view for a digital twin. In the third part, this standard identifies observable manufacturing elements that should be represented as digital models. Part 4 identifies technical requirements for information visualization and information exchange between entities within the reference. Moreover, it is important to highlight that an ad hoc group inside a joint technical committee, JTT1, has been made up for analyzing applications of digital twins and develop a standard to be used as a reference for practitioners. Regarding the first part of this standard under development, it provides an overview and a general principle, and in particular, the standard proposes, first of all, a domain-based reference model of a digital twin. These domains are classified into four categories, as you can see. And in particular, we have user domain, core domain, data collection and device control domain, observable manufacturing domain. Well, starting from the bottom of this diagram, we have the observable manufacturing domain. It consists of physical manufacturing resources, such as personnel, equipment, materials, process, facility, and the data collection and device control domain monitors and collects data from sensory devices, and it controls and actuates devices in the observable manufacturing domain. The core domain is responsible for overall operation and management of digital twins for manufacturing, including provisioning, managing, monitoring, and optimization. The core domain hosts applications and services such as simulation and analysis. In the user domain, the term user can be human, a device, an application, or a system that uses applications and services provided by the core domain. In the second part of the standard, 23247, the standard proposes an entity-based reference and a functional view. In the figure, you can see the entity-based reference model. It breaks down the digital twin for manufacturing into system level in conjunction with domain concepts. In particolare, in this figure, the core entity consists of operation and management subsystems, application and service subsystems, and resource access and interchange. While data collection and device control entity include data collection sub-entities that collect information from observable manufacturing elements with monitoring and sensing devices. The core entity uses the collected information to synchronize the digital twin with the corresponding observable elements. Device control sub-entity that controls and actuates the observable elements, such as computer numerical control or password. The user entity can be any entity utilized the digital twin for manufacturing, including human, device, manufacturing execution system, enterprise resource planning system, and many others. Finally, the cross-system entity is an entity that resides across domains to provide common functionality, such as data translation, data assurance, and security support. The same part two of this standard proposes a functional view of the digital twin. This functional view explains what functionalities entities are included in each domain. As you can see in this video. Well, the part three of 23247 standard identifies the observable manufacturing elements that should be represented in a digital twin model for manufacturing. In particular, digital representation of observable manufacturing elements should consider both static and dynamic information. According to this approach, information that does not change during manufacturing is classified as a static, while information that changes during manufacturing is classified as dynamic. For example, the serial number of a machine is a static information. However, the amount of the shape of material during manufacturing processes can be dynamic information. The digital twin standard 23247 uses notation taken from other standards for identifying attributes and observable manufacturing elements. In particular, standards such as I-62-264 Part 2 and ISO 10-303 contain detailed information models for representing the observable manufacturing elements. For instance, the table in this slide, it shows the template used for describe the information attributes for personnel. These include identification number, for instance, characteristics, status, location, and so on. This notation, in particular, is taken from the standard IEC 62-264 part 2. And personnel includes employees who are engaged directly or indirectly in manufacturing processes. Well, the information attribute must be collected for every observable manufacturing element. This table shows an example for equipment information to be collected. In this case, equipment is defined as a physical element that carries out an operation directly or indirectly for manufacturing processes. This is only another example that concern material information. The term material in this case includes physical matter that becomes a part of the whole of a product, like metal block, glass panel, or is used to aid the information process, like cleaning fluid. Well, finally, the part four of the standard under development on digital twin identifies technical requirements for information synchronization and information exchange within the different entities that incur in the digital twin. In particular, this figure shows an example of how information may be exchanged within a digital twin framework using currently available communication protocols. For instance, only as an example, the access network should provide a standardized method for delivering data for digital twin. Well, now I want to move to present you a case study that involves myself together with other colleagues from University of Parma and La Sapienza. This is a project founded by National Institute for Occupational Injury and Accident that regards the development of a digital twin to prevent operations risk in process planning. In particular, three specific models of digital twin have been developing in this project. The first one regards a two-phase plant located in the UNIPM lab. The second one regards a food plant located in the University of Parma, and the last one refers to a pharmaceutical plant of a private company. Well, in the next slide, I will focus on only on the first plant, and so about the plant located in UNIPM lab. The reference model of the proposed digital twin is shown in the figure. This reference model allowed us to, first of all, create a virtual process for both static and dynamic analysis of the physical industrial process. Secondly, the system propagated this information to other interconnected and achievable digital objects to increase the safety of involved actors. Finally, the system intercepts anomalies at the beginning so as to be able to intervene promptly in order to minimize the damage from breakage or support preventive and predictive measures. This reference model is made up of four main layers. The first one, that we call the process industry physical space, consists of all physical resources that we aim at controlling. In our case, we have personal equipment, materials, and processes. In the second layer, the communication system is dedicated to transfer data or information between digital twins and plant entities. Physical elements are sensed and monitored by control devices and execution tools with the different devices. To complete the second layer, a 3D model representation and a risk identification and assessment plan are needed in order to set up the simulation system and the anomaly prediction system. The core of the digital twin is the third layer. This layer consists of four main systems. The first one, the control and execution tool, allows the physical system to communicate with the cyber system through sensors, transducers, actuators, switches, and so on. The simulation tool allowed the company to create virtual modeling of the process. The anomaly detection and prediction tool is devoted to predict why faults are occurring, what are the causes, and how long the system can work before it breaks or goes out of the current plant operating parameters. The cloud service platform acquires and collects real-time data from the field. This platform is designed for data acquisition, sorting, and visualization. The last layer is the user space. Different interface programs have been developing for activating operational instructions for maintenance and safety management of the system through artificial intelligence and through augmented and virtual reality. And moreover, for the activation, other programs, other software, have been developed for the activation of working message through wearable system. The path for developing these digital twin models proposed in the previous section is divided into five phases, as you can see from the screen. Now we reach the phase three of this project. In particular, in the first phase, a risk assessment plan has been developed in order to identify and analyze all possible adverse events, the causes of these events, and the internal and external risk factors by observing the plant, its processes, and dynamics that characterize it. In the second phase, according to the risk analysis carried out in the first phase, the communication system is developed to define what entity must be monitored. In particular, this strategy is performed according to this approach. First of all, we use existing sensors already present in the plant. Then, for pressure and flow rate control, we insert new sensors into existing infrastructure. Finally, we define and insert actuators for controlling and reducing risk when working methods occur. The third phase focuses on the design development of the tools used in the digital twin. In this work, machine learning algorithms have been used for anomaly detection and prediction. In parallel to the machine learning tool, the simulation tool is also developed at this stage. In our case study, this tool will be used to simulate physical processes. In the phase four, the developed tools will be integrated into ad hoc platform. The platform will perform the data acquisition, data manipulation, detection, prognostic assessment, and advice generation. Finally, the testing phase, phase five, will allow us to collect quantitative data to evaluate the performance of proposed solutions and validate them with particular attention to the benefits in terms of operation. This is the plant used as a case study in an experimental plant located inside the laboratory of the Department of Industrial Engineering and Mathematical Science of Polytechnic University of Paris. The plant simulates a classic situation that occurs in oil and gas expansion processes. In the real case, the treated fluids are crude oil and natural gas, while in the experimental plant, water and air are used. In particular, these experimental plants, an injector is used with water as a motive fluid and air as a suction fluid. The two-phase mixture formed at the injector outlet flows into a pressure vessel, which acts as a vertical separator of the liquid and gas component. The development of a risk identification and assessment plan allowed us to identify typical anomalies and faults of this plan. The main faults are summarized in this slide, and they have been reproduced intentionally using some values inserted in the plan. This is the main advantage of using a laboratory. We had the possibility to simulate anomalies in a very short time. Then we can repeat the test several times, and we can train the simulation and machine learning algorithm on the basis of this test. So, as already explained, first of all, the plant is equipped with a series of sensors, such as pressure, force, water level sensors, that allowed us to monitor the process. The table on the right describes the sensors, valves, and actuators equipped on the plant. Moreover, it is developed a platform that provides application programming interface with related authentication in order to manage data input from the PLC, elaborate them about data analysis tools, and then visualize them for components. Moreover, this is a platform that manages data coming from sensors and from simulated models for what-if scenarios, and then for a relative comparison with the real and the physical. Regarding the graphical model, for the realization of a digital twin, all components have been reproduced using computer-aided design tools, and then using rendering tools. You can see some models in the figure inserted in the slide. Regarding the simulation model of the system, it is realized using macro-stimuli environment. In particular, a supervised approach is used for all components that are too complex to model through closed equations or through computational fluid dynamics simulation software. In particular, the ejector simulation model was very complex. Despite the extensive use of ejector, it is a complex to predict the mixture characteristics, especially when we operate with multi-phase flow, as in our case. For this reason, swarm intelligent algorithms and neural networks have been used for the ejector digital twin realization. Well, our simulation tool can work online or offline. In particular, the inputs come from the sensor in the first case, or can be entered manually in the second case. When working offline through a virtual representation of a physical asset, the tools allow us to analyze what is scenarios without the need to physically realize them, thus avoiding potential situation of risk for operators. In the case where the tools work online, it must be able to receive information from the sensor, obviously, specific class. And it modifies its parameter when the asset changes its condition. The online application can allow a company to have the comparison between the data provided by the simulation. Well, regarding the anomaly detection tool, in order to analyze the different anomalies, different faults, it was necessary to monitor the operating parameters of the plant, such as flow rate and working pressure of the two fluids, haze and water. Moreover, the level of pressure on the tank and many other parameters. It was observed how these values change when anomalies occur. Then, for anomaly detection, several artificial neural network structures have been implemented and subsequently evaluated in terms of accuracy. A cross-validation was performed to best networks. The network trained for each iteration was used to evaluate the accuracy and precision of the anomaly prediction through an external data set, not used in the training phase. As already said, different application programming interfaces have been developing for monitoring and predicting the plant risk. Through wearable systems, it will be possible to monitor, for example, the distance of operators from the plant and send alerts in case the cyber-physical system foresees risk situations, such as a burst or an overpression in some part of the system, and sending operational instructions for the maintenance and the management of the system through augmented reality and virtual reality solutions. Well, the following key points need more attention in digital twin development. Firstly, the core of any digital twin is a high-fidelity virtual model. To this end, it is critical to fully understand the physical world. Otherwise, the virtual model cannot correspond effectively with the physical world. Another key point about the virtual model regards its attributes. This model must be characterized by high standardization, modularization, lightweight, and robustness. In particular, the standardization is intended to facilitate information sharing and integration. Modularization increases the flexibility, scalability, and reusability, while lightweight reduces information transfer time, cost, and finally, robustness of the model is important to deal with various uncertainties. Other critical aspects for implementing digital twin solutions in a real industrial context can be summarized in the following form. Now, IoT is not perfectly industrial IoT. So this means that the industrial version of devices requires resilient, robust, and reliable solutions, which are subject to industrial regulation and different standards. Today, the solutions on the market in many cases do not perfectly meet its needs in terms of performance, flexibility, compared to the industrial requirements. Moreover, when the number of pervasive devices is large, factors such as energy consumption and the energy supply, life cycle and maintenance of components such as sensors become critical. Moreover, different relevant standardization issues need to be addressed. For instance, the standardization regarding the synchronization of the physical object and its digital system. The syntax and semantic interoperability to ensure interoperability across digital twins and security protection of a physical entity and its associated characteristics. Finally, regarding the standards that are being developed, these standards leave open research gaps that need to be covered in the future. In particular, gaps regarding the selection of methods, technology, devices to be used for specific manufacturing sectors, and specific processes and products to be represented in a digital tool. So thank you for your kind attention. At the bottom, you will see my reference. And in the last slide, you can find the reference used in this presentation, where I take some figures and okay. Thank you. Okay. Matteo.
Yes.
Do you want to open the discussion as you want?
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Filippo. It is very interesting. This dissertation and the contents that you provided are really useful, I think, for the participants to this workshop, also in view of the contents of their presentation that have been showed yesterday. I wish to ask to the present any remark, any questions to Professor Ciarapica? I think we have, don't know, I don't see any request of speaking. Anyone? Okay, I think that we may close the meeting at this stage. Again, thanking Professor Ciarapica for this contribution that is archived in YouTube, and it will be also available in terms of slides on the website of the workshop. Filippo, do you have to add something? Do you hear us? Are you able to hear? I am phoning him because he was just phoning me. Maybe there is some problem on the connection. Filippo, ma tu mi senti? Ma tu stavi andando avanti? Sì, perché adesso sono il relatore io. Riavviando, sì, riavvia. Un attimo solo. Ci vediamo qui. Ok, there is some connection problems regarding Professor Ciarapica, who is coming back in a few seconds here in the meeting. So, in the while, I wish to ask you again if someone wants to start a discussion regarding this contribution. Okay. I think we don't have any remark or any question regarding this. So, for the working group, we shall now start the working group at noon, at 12. We shall communicate you the working group of the meeting and the related tutors. These tutors will then have a dedicated meeting room to work with the group that has been assigned to them. So for the moment, the meeting is completed in terms of seminar and will continue at noon, 12 p.m. With the formation of the working group and the start of the working sessions. Okay? We shall then see within an hour since now. Thank you to all, and thank you to Professor Ciarapica for his contribution. Thanks a lot. Thank you.